Behind every intelligent response from AI models like GPT, Gemini, DeepSeek, and many others lies a mountain of computation. And it all runs on huge power-hungry GPUs that cost millions of dollars. But what if there was a better way? Faster, cheaper, and way more efficient? Welcome to the future of AI hardware, driven not by processors, but by memory. This is the story of resistive memory, a memory that computes. All AI models use billions of parameters called weights. These are stored in big grids called matrices. To train the model or make predictions, the models have to do calculations with these matrices and the input vectors, which are number version or encodings of things like images or text. So to work, AI systems keep doing the same thing again and again, multiplying vectors with matrices. And it's no easy task. For a large number of matrices and vectors of humongous sizes. Let's first explore how this is done in conventional computing using CPUs and GPUs. Vector matrix product is calculated using a sequence of multiply-accumulate operations. In this operation, the dot product of the row vector with one column of the matrix is calculated by multiplying each element of the vector with the corresponding element of the matrix column and adding the result to a running sum known as the accumulator. The accumulated sum gives one element of the resulting vector. The process is repeated for all the columns of the matrix to obtain the output vector. GPUs were built to do this fast, using thousands of small cores to perform these multiply-accumulate operations in parallel, dramatically speeding up the process. But the number of computational steps needed for vector matrix multiplication, aka its computational complexity, increases roughly in proportion to the number of elements or the size of the matrix. And here's the real catch. The weights live in memory, the inputs are pulled from memory, and the results must be written back to memory. That means every single computation step needs constant data movement back and forth between the processor and the memory. As a result, even the mightiest GPU is ultimately held back by its slowest part, the memory bandwidth. It's like having a Formula One car stuck in traffic. This is known as the memory wall, a growing gap between memory and compute. Every time data moves back and forth, it burns energy and time, and that adds up fast. In most AI workloads, over 60% of the time and 90% of the energy is spent just moving data, not computing. And as AI models scale up, so does the problem, thanks to the computational complexity of the vector matrix multiplications. The question is, what if memory didn't just store data? What if it could compute too in a much less complex way? Resistive memory is a new kind of memory. It doesn't store data using electric charge, like traditional memory. Instead, it uses resistance. Each memory cell is like a tiny sandwich, made of two metal layers with an insulator in between. When a voltage pulse is applied, the atomic structure inside the insulator changes, either by migration of metal ions or by shifting defects, or altering how it's crystallized. This change affects how easily current flows through it, its conductance. By changing the number and polarity of the voltage pulses, the conductance of the device can be increased or decreased in a controlled and predictable way. Different levels of conductance can then be used to store both digital and analog values. But here's where it gets interesting. Resistive memory devices can be arranged in a crossbar structure. In this setup, memory cells sit at the points where rows and columns of metal wires cross. Each cell connects one row to one column. By setting each cell to a specific conductance value, an entire weight matrix is stored in the memory. The input vector is applied as voltages along the rows of the crossbar. Thanks to Ohm's law, the current through each memory cell is the product of the applied voltage and the cell's conductance. That's multiply operation. Then Kirchhoff's law kicks in. The current from all the cells in each column add up all by themselves. That's accumulate. The total current flowing out of each column becomes one element of the output vector. So, we have just completed an entire vector matrix multiplication in a single computation step, using far less energy. Every cell works at the same time. No loops, no data movement to load weights, no memory bottleneck. Just pure parallel computing, right inside the memory. This is in-memory computing. It cuts down number of computational steps and data movement drastically, unlocking unmatched energy efficiency. Recent studies show that resistive memory-based AI systems can deliver up to 10 to 420 TOPS per watt. That is 10 to 30 times more performance per watt than a modern GPU. And the cherry on top? Resistive memory is non-volatile. It remembers the weights even with the power off. For AI on your phone, a drone, or any edge device, that means models stay stored and you get instant-on performance. Of course, resistive memory isn't perfect. Its performance is hampered by issues like conductance drift, read and programming noise, cell-to-cell variations, and low precision due to limited number of discrete conductance states. Analog computing also requires ADCs and DACs, adding cost and complexity. Still, resistive memory's advantages far outweigh its limitations, and researchers are rapidly improving the precision, device variability, noise, and endurance issues of resistive memories. For decades, computers followed a simple rule: memory stores, processors compute. But resistive memory changes that. It blurs the line, making memory the processors. It promises faster, cheaper, and massively efficient AI. GPUs got us here, but the future of AI may be written in resistive memory.